I just can't let you live in a place like this, Adrian. This whole damn house is soaked with my sorrow. And this chair that was my prison for years. I can't let you take this place. Not like this.
Thank you.
much to you, trying to calm you down when you cried. I tried to use it for myself after the therapy, but I had different words coming to mind when I did. It was the doctor's fault. It was the doctor's fault. Then I made sure that voice was silenced. Thank you. appreciate that he was there for me after her death.
Thank you. People say that after a while, every piece gets to its place in our lives. I hope your story will be the same, Adrian. I want you to know that I tried to do everything on your behalf. Even if you saw it differently while standing on the stairs of the orphanage. After your mother passed away, I couldn't raise you properly. I just couldn't do it. I want you to understand that I didn't want you to see the things I've done after your mother's death. I'm not proud of what I've done. But now I'm trying to do what's right. I went to many anonymous meetings at the hospital, talked to people with the same story as mine, and I figured out that I'm not alone. With my flaws and mistakes. After these sorrowful years, I think a lot about our memories. When we played on the merry-go-round for hours, or when we took a wrong turn on a hike and ended up in the forest for half a day before we found our way out. I'm sorry I wasn't there when you needed me. I will regret it forever. Some months ago, I figured out how I could help you, so I started to clean up stains from the walls I did in the past. In the box, you'll find a key and an address. I hope this will help you in your brand new life, so you become the man I always imagined you as an adult. I'm very proud of you, my son. For the path you went through. For how strong you are to be here. I hope we can meet once more and talk like father and son. It doesn't matter where our story took the wrong turn. You can be proud of yourself and look into the future.